listening to Jan Talk.
Go.
We in the jungle, baby.
Number one.
All right, welcome to Jan Talk. You know what I'm saying? We are here another night. But we tonight we're talking about the council culture. What can I say? We got two guests. First guest, it's the boy D.Green. You know what I'm saying? We go back like some college day, you know what I'm saying? These talk we used to have at in college at the table, you know what I'm saying? We appreciate you coming on tonight.
Appreciate y'all having me.
All right, appreciate it.
And we got my boy John. I knew him. Probably met John around 2010, 2011 ish, but we keep in contact over Facebook. I see him around Columbus from time to time out and about. So I decided to bring him along on the show on this topic. And this is my boy John. Shout out to D Green too. I ain't seen him since Columbus Tech.
No, they're right.
What's up, everybody? Gen Tech, what's happening?
What's going on? So man, like basically, you know what I'm saying? We're talking about council culture. It has ruined freedom of speech now. Everybody, you can't say nothing. Like everybody's sensitive. We are the most hypocritical country ever. Like everybody love judge, love saying something about somebody, but in the same regards, you can't say nothing. Like say nothing, nobody. Like you can't say nothing, or you can't make no jokes. Nothing. Everybody so sensitive. Pretty much kill comedy. Like this is why comedy is suffering. Music suffering. Like so much shit suffering from the council culture. You know. And who wanna go first? Spill on.
Well, I started off. Council culture, you know, it's pretty new school. Shit, you know, especially in high school and stuff, shit, we've been doing cancel culture ever since we came up in school, to be honest with you. You know, I think it's all like a part of a system and customs and just the way America has been brought it up. You know, I tell people all the time, things are in cycles and phases and ways. Like, there's stuff that has been inflicted on our people from slavery days since we came over here that's just been passed down, and we subconsciously do things that just affects people and like with their psyche and stuff. So, you know, some people, they're like, oh, get over it and all that. But at the same time, it's kind of like we've been brought up that way. But you got other people who have kind of grown out of that over the times, because I feel like we're a lot more intelligent, of course, over time. But it's kind of like, okay, why are we accepting this? So we're kind of like not being so subconscious. We're kind of like thinking about certain things. And don't get me wrong, like it's not good to be sensitive and stuff, but I always say there's always more than one way to do things. So with cancel culture, it's kind of like, okay, you could target Pepe Le Pew or whoever the hell else, but like that's not doing nothing, you know? That's like symbolic liberation. Like it's just a symbol. It doesn't mean nothing beside the person that's behind it. But you go after people that's actually like can run stuff. You know, maybe people that's over like, you know, your local judicial system and stuff like that. That's a little bit different because it's actually effective. You know, it's actually something that affects you. But all this little symbolic stuff, like, that's not doing nothing. Who cares if you cancel a college football player? Because, hell, they're going to find another one. You know, that's not hurting nothing. Or who cares if you do a cartoon character? Or, hell, even, like, some person in leadership, they're just going to find somebody else. You know? So I just think, yeah, you just need to re-strategize it towards people that's actually running stuff versus, like, symbolic shit that's really not going to mean nothing, you know?
Yeah, I feel you on that. Thing with the symbolic. What about you, D-Green?
Man, shit, man. Council culture, man, it got so many facets to it, I believe, that go into it. You know what I'm saying? It's definitely a lot of people being soft, you know what I'm saying? But there's so many facets, like generational gaps, how we were raised versus how our parents raised us, what we see as true and what we don't, what the next generation see as true is what it don't. Like, I can understand why some of these people canceling, trying to do cancel culture, like the younger generation, because they learn from the internet, you know what I'm saying? They ain't had that same kind of structure that we had and that same kind of teachings from whether you got it from your streets or your parents that let you know, like, hey, this is common sense. This ain't real. Nobody's gonna take this literally. No, they take shit off the internet literally. You know what I'm saying? especially this young generation. They look at someone in there and that shit literal to them. So when they see something that's showing them stuff that they've been seeing on the internet that they think is wrong, you know what I'm saying? They probably think if we get it off, then the next generation won't do it. You know what I'm saying? And that's just like a little spill on that shit. Cause you know, I can go in for 12 hours on this shit, but like, you know what I'm saying? But like, I feel like it's a real complex equation. You know what I'm saying? Why people doing this, that leads all the way back to how you raise, how society works. Businesses knowing that our generation and the next generation are the ones making money, buying shit right now. We in our 30s, but we making the money. We buying the shit. We filling the houses up. We at the stores right now. We in our prime when it comes to financial business. We finally getting our cut. Businesses know that. So when we say something, they're going to listen versus if a Gen X or somebody says something. You know what I'm saying? So they trying to cater to us and cater to Gen Z because they don't want that money to walk away because we're not loyal. Our generation and the next generation ain't loyal people to businesses. We loyal to what we believe is right. You know what I'm saying? So they got to do whatever we believe is right. And if they think that's counseling, they're going to go right along with it.
Yeah. Anybody else? Anybody next? Keisha?
Yeah. So I guess, so who's been canceled recently that y'all feel like shouldn't have been canceled?
Pepe Le Fruit. We understand what was happening. I understand what was happening, but come on now. It's like sometimes shit be going too far. Like get to a point now. It's like if you a celebrity or even an influence, you gotta walk on edge, you know. Right. You can say, I don't like green. Somebody's offended by it. Just because you don't like a certain color or a certain brand or you don't agree with something. You can't even disagree with nobody anymore. Because it's gonna turn into a problem. You discriminate or some shit gonna come out of that. So it just, I don't know. They're too much, man. No, I just.
Well, I mean, honestly, I don't necessarily think a lot of the stuff that's been canceled didn't have been canceled. There have been certain things. You know, that I think what it is with me, freedom of speech is out there, but people also take advantage of that shit, too. Just because you have the freedom to say it doesn't necessarily mean it needs to be said. You know what I'm saying? Like, it'd be a lot of times people be out there just saying shit just to get a reaction out of it. And if that's the case, if you got an opinion and you don't even have no basis behind the opinion or nothing you want to do with that opinion, you just want to piss somebody off, what's the point?
I agree with that 1,000. It's a dangerous time we're living in with this internet, man. Like, so much misinformation gets spread. Nobody does their research because to them, the internet is the research. And like where I work at, we got to scout everybody to make sure they ain't being verbally abused at home. You know what I'm saying? If they're getting verbally abused, like we might take your kid, your elder from you. We might get you some time in jail. You know what I'm saying? If you're grilling somebody like that. But when you outside that situation in the normal world and you're being raised or you're doing extra stuff like that, that's not verbal abuse. That's freedom of speech. You know what I'm saying? So where that line at? You know, it's confusing to me.
We don't know where the line at for real.
Where is the line now for real? Because
I mean, yeah. I don't really know. Like, I can't really think of nobody that's been canceled that I don't be caring about that shit for real. But I can't really think of nobody that's been canceled that shouldn't have been canceled for real. Now, every sometimes I be thinking, okay, y'all reaching, like y'all really reaching. It ain't that serious. I do think that do be the case. But I think people that have, if you know that you have, if you're in the spotlight, if you know that you have a platform, you should be you should be able to hire people to make sure that you don't make these mistakes. Like, okay, if you have a certain view on sexuality and this, that, and the third, okay, you're entitled to your opinion, but the entire world don't need to hear you say something offensive to them, you know? If that makes sense. Like, I don't think it's necessary a lot of times. I think people just take advantage of their freedom of speech. And a lot of times it's usually the white community that does that shit. You know, I got the freedom to say whatever I want to say. Yeah, you do, but you also got the right to get your ass beat behind some of the shit you say too. Like, for real. Yep.
what you gotta say about it, Chef?
I'm just listening in, y'all. I want to hear what y'all got to say.
Hey, what's up? I know somebody else up in here.
Well, like I say, honestly, I feel like I'm coming back in the day with Eddie Murphy, Raw, and Richard Pryor and stuff, but ain't no way that shit was surviving now. They were saying,
oh, nah,
everything. This shit,
though. Now they trying to keep comedy free, though. You know what I'm saying? They trying to keep comedy a safe zone. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people allowing that. That's when you see nobody targeting like Dave Chappelle and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. Dave Chappelle play with him. He wanted to say.
I don't know how long that's going to hold up because, you know, comedy is like supposed to be subjective. But like we live in the age now where everybody's like, oh, okay, we're all offended by something. Maybe we should just stop it all. But I think that's the direction where we're kind of headed, you know?
But, because I mean, hell, like Richard Pryor been talking shit forever.
Different like, generation too, though. Like they're more offensive than him.
Still, like, like D.Green said. I mean, they're trying to cater to our generation. This is our generation. Grew up on that, so it's more so. I don't really think it's more so trying to cater to us. It's just more so just trying to. I don't know. When it comes to this canceling shit, I really do see race as a huge factor in it. To be honest with you.
Yeah, it does. It really does. Race and religion. Those are the two main things.
You know why? It doesn't have nothing to do with class or anything like that because, hell, you can call somebody, I can call a man a broke-ass nigga today. You know what I'm saying? They ain't gonna cancel me for saying that shit. You know what I'm saying? But if he called me happy-headed hoe, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's a whole...
You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, if a white man called me a nappy-headed hoe, it's going to be on and popping. But if I was to call him broke, it's not going to be no problem behind that. So, you know, it's really, I really do think, yeah, a lot of it has a lot to do with your race, too. So,
me personally, though, I think it do got a lot to do with class. Because, like, I mean, when you think of the concept of racism, like, it really is about economics. Like, people can sit here and say, oh, it's about skin color and stuff don't matter. But it's really the history behind your skin color and what it has pertaining to your country. You know, like, people don't like black folks pretty much because, like, black folks was the reason why the South went to the Depression, to be real. You know, because, like, black people, they weren't making no money.
Hey. And, what?
I'm saying, like, stuff that goes down to economics. Is what I'm saying. So it's like when you talk about class, like we may say stuff about race now, but in the future, like it can be all about like class. Cause nobody, let's be honest, nobody really cares if you're black but you're successful. Hell, even the closet races are going to like you. You
what know, the take hell? Trump.
I'm just saying, like take Trump for example. You know, like we'll call him racist all day, but to be real, he just don't like broke folks. And you know,
yeah, don't make you keep saying that. Man, keep saying that a while ago. I said Trump is not racist.
People.
I mean, don't get me wrong, he's racist, but we gotta realize there's different forms of racism. You got black racism, which is like more traditional. You got economical racism. You got ignorant racism. You got all types. Like, it's just not like one form. And that's why I be trying to tell folks, too. Like, we talk about, like, broke folks this and broke folks that. But to be real, the middle class should be the people sticking together out of everybody because really the war gonna come to our ass. These rich folks, they the ones really against us. You know, I'm not gonna say every single one of them. But I'm talking about the real rich folks. You know,
yeah,
that's just my opinion, though.
So I see with the cancel culture. I see where it come from. I see why it's here. I believe it's gonna stop when they take it just one too many times, too many steps, too far. They let you cancel who they're gonna let you cancel who they let you cancel. They're not gonna let them cancel Eminem. You know, people trying to throw that up. That shit got squashed immediately. You know what I'm saying? But I can see where it come from because, like I said, we got the young people looking at the internet and stuff, and they see years and years of just blatant racism, blatant sexism, and then you got people sitting there saying, oh, no, it's not even that deep. That's not what's happening. Even now, you know, even though it's right in the face, kind of like with the global warming shit. And then, so that I believe this next generation behind us is trying to make sure that shit dead right then and there because they're not having it. Like I had a coworker that said some slick shit to her son, and her son was appalled that she would say something like that. that was off the wall, you know what I'm saying? You know, and she a conservative, you know what I'm saying? And bro tried to hang himself because of what she said. Because he couldn't believe his mama was that kind of person. These young folks ain't playing. They ain't with the shit, bro. No, they ain't with it. They trying to squash all that shit. And they going to the extreme because they young. You know what I'm saying? And they going to the extreme. And then at the same time, they humans and you giving them some power. They see if they do this, this reaction can happen. Now they want to target everything. You know what I'm saying? No, it's a bunch of young people trying to do what they young people do. So, I mean, people going to get canceled, but only who the companies let get canceled. You know what I'm saying? Like, they don't care about Pepe Le Pew. That nigga ain't making them niggas no money. You know what I'm saying?
That shit was random as hell, though.
Yeah, I thought it was a joke, man. I ain't even know that joke was serious, but that shit's serious. You know, even the whole Mr. Potato Head thing.
Yeah.
That was... For real?
Yeah, they
killed
something
real.
Why?
Well, they ain't careful. They changed them. They made them trans.
They made them what?
No, they make them trans. They made them non-gender, and then when you buy them, you can make them whatever you want to. Potato head.
I know about the potato head. Yeah, I thought that was just ridiculous. Like, seriously, like, this whole gender equality shit is outrageous. Like, it's a fucking toy. Like, for real.
Right.
I'm trying to figure out what
you're forcing on kids. I don't like this shit. You're forcing sexuality on kids. I don't like it.
Yeah. Did you see that shit I posted?
Yeah.
Yeah.
My thing is, by something in the past that's been going on, ain't bothered nobody's all of a sudden a problem.
Why are they changing him and there was a Mrs. Potato Head? What's the point? Like, y'all satisfied both genders.
Like, the sad thing is, the dude had died, the one that played him. So it's like, I don't even know why they still messing with the character.
All right, where's he? If it's a, what do y'all want, a non-binary potato head?
I think male, female,
non-binary. That's what they should do in the story.
Yeah, I guess because he'd be changing parts and stuff.
Just let the toys sit up there and speak for themselves. That's what they should do. Male, female, non-binary. Which I'm going to have the most toys at the end of the year after Christmas. I'm like, yeah, y'all see how ridiculous this shit is? Like, come on. Nobody's giving a damn. Like, for real. If your son want to play with dolls, then play with dolls. Like, just go get a doll. It ain't got to be a...
action figure. That's what they used to say.
I ain't even know kids still play with toys.
Right.
Mine do. Shit. She make it very well. We can't even go to... Can we go to the toy aisle, Mom? No, because you're not getting anything.
I think they really trying to do? They trying to get rid of the term male and female.
Yeah. You
know, I do too, ultimately. Yeah.
It's the ultimate goal.
Yeah. I'm trying to get male or female, but y'all still letting this racism shit. I mean, can we address one situation at a time? Let's get through racism first. Then we'll get through sexism and all of that shit. God damn.
Racism ain't making money, but. The other shit is making them money. Racism,
I ain't gonna front. I think racism making us money too, for real. Everybody using marketing tool and pandering and propaganda, and stuff, you know,
just like that bullshit. And they pandering that down when they, you know, when everybody putting the fist up in their logo with all these
right.
The fist, like I was over that shit. I was like, man, I know all these y'all don't do this shit.
But something needed. I mean, awareness needed to be brought. Like, for real, it's getting ridiculous. Like, the number of black men that are being killed by the police is getting ridiculous. So yes, it was finally. It was like, goddamn, finally, y'all realizing this shit ridiculous. Like, for real.
I understand.
I'm being honest with you. If a bigger company put a Black Lives Matter symbol. And they place will stop our black men from being killed, then by all means necessary, do it. Like, for real. Because we have been around for so fucking long, and everybody just been sending a blind eye to it. We have been dealing with this since the start of our race. Brutally, just because of what we look like. So, yes, I am perfectly fine with these companies. Even if it's not what they really believe in, I don't give a fuck. The fact of the matter is, y'all telling the world, y'all stand behind black folks. So when time comes, you know you gotta live up to your word, because you know there's still a lot of websites now that still have their disclaimer on there, how they support the Black community, how they feel like this social injustice is wrong. All right, then cool. Maybe they'll chill out on that bullshit after a while when they realize, okay, yeah, the whole world is gonna be on our neck. Like for real.
Switch over to Asians now.
Yeah, they don't switch. They don't switch.
Yeah. Never. They seen that joke being overused. They gonna switch to another race. We gonna get money from them.
Say it. As fucked up as this sound, I hate that that happened right here in Atlanta. Not to mention those Asians. Honestly, if they were Black, it would be a way bigger outroar.
But ain't nobody
caring about Asians right now. Like they still getting on the Black people bandwagon. They are not really caring about Asians right now. Because honestly speaking, the coverage on it was literally like a day. This was a terroristic act that was done on American soil by a white man. This should have been brought outrage across the world, not just Asia. Like for real, the Asians over there ain't even giving a damn for real. Because hell, they think the Asians over here too white. So, yeah. You know, like, for real, it's real, real, real fucked up what happened. I don't think the outrage behind it was as big as it should have been, but I don't think racism is going to transpire over to the Asians. I don't. It's going to always be with us Black folks for a while. Now, if anybody's next, it's the Hispanics.
Oh, yeah, they've been kind of neck and neck.
Yeah.
Hey, that's what I said, but no Hispanic be, man, the motherfucker be off the radar, dog.
Yeah, they lay low. And now you know what I they like about when I, you know what I'm saying, when I worked in like the facility with kids, they just like this. They tight. You cannot buy a Spanish Hispanics. They gonna stick. They
exactly. That's in jail, period. Yeah. Like, if you go to jail, all the different races stick together, the white folks together, the Black folks together, the Asians together, the Hispanics are together. Like for real. So
I ain't never been to this home.
I remember working in the facility where all the Hispanic kids, they were together with each other.
Or if there's just one, the Black people gonna try to recruit him. That's all I seen when I worked though. He gonna speak one lick of English, but they had him doing everything they wanted him to do.
Shoot, man, we just gotta make sure we get our cut too, man. So it's like everybody marketing off Black Lives Matter and all that. Like, shoot, it ain't gonna mean nothing. We ain't getting something from it. And that's what we gotta realize too. You know,
exactly. Yeah. We gotta get that money from them. Get some, not necessarily money, but yeah, like it got something. Yeah, we gotta get our cut. Fuck this shit. We need something from this shit. Like this, Black people are the number one they number one marketer. Whatever Black people buy into, that shit gonna
skyrocket.
Yeah,
but it be 1,000 with y'all. But I think this racist shit finna start dwindling down real hard in the next 10 years, bro. Like I really believe that shit. When I be talking to the old ass people and these young people I be dealing with, that shit gonna be on the demand. Like Trump was like the last ditch stand. You know what I'm saying? Like he brought up to the surface all the racist motherfuckers, you know what I'm saying? And them motherfuckers trying to gather, and then as soon as they did, like, that's when the cancel culture popped off, bro. You know what I'm saying? And these young niggas is coming for their necks, and they don't care who they got to destroy and what they got to take to do that shit, bro. So I think in the next 10 years, that shit, it's going to still be racist, because those going to be racist. But I think that shit going to get real dwindled down, dog, like, for a while, because these niggas come for their neck.
Yeah. The discussion of racism is going to be, it's a lot more prevalent than how it was. Racism is one of those things that we would deal with, but we would not really speak on in the forefront. But like the discussion of racism is all over everywhere right now. So I do agree with that, you know, after a while, if you come across somebody that's, I think in about 10 years, yeah, somebody says some racist shit, you like, damn, still on that?
Yeah. That shit go.
It's got to make you wonder too, though, man. What's next?
It's 2021.
I don't know what could be next for real. I think it's going like John said, it's going to be a cycle. because like they going too hard with it, and you know when people push themselves too hard on other people, they fight back eventually. You know what I'm saying? So I think it's gonna die down, and then it's like gonna come back around, especially with the sexism. The racism might not come back as hard, but the sexism will, because you know how ridiculous they getting with the genders and the kids and shit. That shit gonna bounce back hard. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So I think that's what's gonna be next. It's gonna be a whole nother apply to sexism and shit.
Shoot, I got a theory on interracial takeover, man. Be honest with you. Like, I don't know how long, but you
thank
know,
you, baby.
Like, everybody mixed in, you know, it's kind of like, especially with the melting pot like America, like they might look at somebody that's like 100% black, white, or whatever, and be like, oh, I don't like this motherfucker for whatever reason, you know. But that's how I be looking at phases and stuff too, though, man. But I just be having my own
opinion. Shit, them niggas, they rare, them niggas gonna be gems, you know what I'm saying? Shit. I hope they don't go down
like that. Like after a while, it's gonna be like, oh wow, you all the way black. You black, right. Black.
Like dark skin folks gonna be rare.
Like I'm a surplus of color. Yeah,
there is a surplus in interracial and biracial children. My wow. I was looking at, what was I looking at? I think it was TV. Like if you ever noticed, like it's a lot more interracial children and couples, yep, on TV now. I think it's good because it shows the evolution that is going on now. But yeah, I do feel like after a while, they're like, oh my God, you're all the way black. Yeah, like my mom and my dad are black. Like, oh wow, interesting. That's exactly how it's going to be in a few years. I can't wait to see their reaction when my daughter say, yeah, I'm black, but you're light skinned.
We got Mike John going on. Mike finally joins.
I think it's Mike. Oh,
Mike, well,
be right back.
Yeah. Yeah, man, it's just like oh yeah, like you said, like yeah, right now I think we're in the mix of a shift. Like you said, a whole lot of shit happening around us, so it'd be so, a lot of times it's so hard to keep up with so much shit happening. Like, shit.
My shit, egg roll, bro. Go.
Hey, you know, people don't like change, bro. Like, legit, you know what I'm saying? So, we seeing all this like drastic change, and we're like, why you fucking with this? Why you fucking with that? But in the long term, like, is that what needs to be done? You know what I'm saying? Whether it be just to prove a point to the older people, like, we shutting shit down. Or if it's just the point of that new people won't come in to see that shit. Like I said, like I was raised with some sense. So I know like when I see Pepe fucking kissing on the other cat and that cat looking terrified that she don't want that shit, so he shouldn't be doing that. You know what I'm saying? But our parents basically had the schools raise us for the most part, not everybody. You know what I'm saying? Well, they were trying to work for their damn retirement plan, you know what I'm saying? And then we had kids. So we just pass on what we know, you know what I'm saying? Well, I ain't had kids, y'all had kids. And then from that point on, these new kids, they ain't catching the same understanding, you know what I'm saying? They're like, shit, then she don't want that shit. Why are we showing this on TV? You know what I'm saying? They need to get this on TV. I don't like that. You know what I'm saying? It upsets them because they can't differentiate that this is just a show and we all understand that that's not right. That's the joke. You know what I'm saying? But you know, they ain't differentiating that, you know what I'm saying? They raised differently.
Yeah, man, definitely that. Especially yeah, like you said, they ain't used to seeing what we like, you know what I'm saying? What we think that what we took as they think is, oh man, this shit ain't right. This is like us, like we like then you like now you come thinking and looking at it, us now looking at shit we used to watch growing up, we like, damn, we started to get questions about the shit. Like you know, you see the shit, especially on the internet now, like damn. That does make shit. Everybody was a parent. They make lore of pedophiles, rapists, all that shit.
For real, man. It was the stuff we used to watch. You be like, how's that on the cartoon when you look at it later? You know what I'm saying? Like, they're telling me, like, he was watching Rugrats, my homeboy on the game, was watching Rugrats with his son. And you know what the little chocolate bars are called that the granddad loves smashing?
Yeah.
They called fudge dinglings, bro. Oh. He be fucking that shit up. You know, that's a blood motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? He be fucking them shit up. What's doing, bro? And I'm like, damn, why they put that on there? They know what the hell ding-a-lings are.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of them cartoons were perverted back then.
Swear, bro. Yeah. I'm telling you, bro, until you got older.
So they're canceled Pepe Le Pew.
Yeah, yeah. They don't cancel him. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he gone. Right.
There he go.
Even on TV.
If you remember him, he always used to be his main skit
was rape. But I mean, to think about it, was like, why are they canceling him now? Is what I'm asking.
That's what I was saying. See, earlier. Why they bringing up old stuff?
But literally,
that's a big problem.
Okay, Pepe Le Pew was raping, like literally attempted rape every episode.
No, because you know he was a skunk, so he would like the. Like kind of like use his smell to like trap women or whoever he was going after and stuff. But I mean, I guess that's the reason why. But I mean, it was a cartoon, so you know.
But
he be kissing all on her, and she be looking terrified.
It's fucked up because it's a cat, so he's trying to take the pussy and shit. That's the fucked up thing about it.
Skunk.
talking about the cat. You always chasing the damn cat.
I don't remember that shit. I don't know that shit.
I guess the thing is, you can look at it from both sides, though, because she always fought back. And she always...
She was more brave. Johnny Bravo holds fought back.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I respect
Johnny Bravo.
Hey, yo. On some real nigga shit. Why we ain't canceling Bugs Bunny? That nigga was harassing Albert Fudd.
Yep. Yeah.
He didn't want to kiss. That nigga wanted to hunt.
Yeah, he was kissing in the mouth.
Yeah, he kissed Michael Jordan, too.
I think Daffy Duck deserves better.
Okay, so because he kissed a man, that's why we cancel him, or what?
It was like a kiss.
It was unwanted, yeah. So right. They should cast some other
You know what? Ah, I like what y'all did with that. You're right. I like what y'all did.
Yeah.
I get it.
Like they was racist against Daffy Duck.
Okay, you were black.
Daffy Duck got no love.
Yeah, they were racist against some bird. That's all racist as hell, Daffy Duck. You deserve better.
Yeah.
Daffy Duck got dirty.
Yeah, he all got dead dirty. Okay, you black. Yeah, don't stick to that shit.
And he the one that always got shot instead of Bug. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They get mad when he's spoke his mind.
But then they also doing like they're looking back on like white actors who play like they did like blackface. Like they did Robert Downey Jr. when he was on Tropic Thunder.
Was funny in Tropic Thunder.
Yeah, it was
funny. That nigga was godly on Tropic Thunder.
The blackface was addressed in the movie. Like it's not but like he tried to end the movie as a white man.
But like if you're gonna go against that movie, there's a whole nother movie like back, I think in the 80s, where a guy did a black face, but nobody going back on talking about that one. I forgot the name.
Ain't nobody gonna talk about that.
Thunder was a hilarious movie. But I think when you're doing blackface to be malicious, then it should be canceled. If you're doing blackface to be an asshole, like for real, like what blackface was, then yes. But what Robert Downey Jr. was doing, it wasn't necessarily blackface. It was a funny-ass character. White man who was cast in a movie as a black man and was trying to appropriate the culture. Like, that was hilarious. I mean, because honestly, after a while, you kind of almost forgot that he was actually white for a bit because he was so damn funny. But
yes, movie.
I ain't gonna let nobody cancel Iron Man.
I can look at stuff like that and I understand what is going on there. I think people just have to be rational when it comes to these type of things. They're not rational. Right. They're moving around trying to make everybody happy. Okay, be rational. Look at the content and actually see what is going on. Pepe Le Pew has never been offensive to me. I've always known how to push a man away. If you're too aggressive, like, you know what I'm saying? No means no. And you know, I know things myself. So the fact that they're doing that, and then the whole Mr. Potato Head, and it's just too damn much. They just finding shit now to be mad about.
Yeah, how I feel too.
What
you guys say about the council culture?
No, I mean. you got some people, you know, just pick and choose who they want to cancel, which is kind of wrong. It's like, we don't even live in a day. I understand you can't, you know, there's no redemption for a pedophile or a murderer or some shit like that, unless it was like self-defense and all that shit. But it's like, we don't live in a day where people can like come back from shit. It's like, oh, you done. You fuck up one time. Oh, it's over for you.
Right.
You done. You done. You done. That's it. No more. No second chances, bitch. It's over with. You know what I'm saying? They still getting on Michael Vick. They trying to cancel Michael Vick for all these years. Oh, okay, he killed dogs. He paid his debt to society and all that shit. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, everybody just like, if people wake up, like, people wake up to get mad about something every day. You know, just to feel, you know, get validated from a group of shit. But nowadays, you just got to go out, you know what I'm saying? If it offends you, you know what I'm saying? Turn it off. If it doesn't offend you, I mean, hey, but you know, you can't please everybody. Everybody's going to be mad about something. So,
you're entitled to your freedom of speech, but just don't take advantage of it. Like,
true.
Especially if you're using your freedom of speech, use it to. You need to actually make some type of change around this bitch. Like, D.Green, I think it was D.Green earlier was saying that people just be talking, just talk. And ain't really making no changes behind the shit that they talking about. Like, for real.
Yeah. People just get on social media, just get validation from other people. Oh, yeah, I agree with you. So, yeah.
It's
all overboard.
No, I think I was the one that said it. Like, people really just be just saying shit just to get a reaction out of people.
Mm-hmm.
That's where it gets annoying, because I'm like, you have this opinion and you have no basis, no proof behind it. I actually stopped doing all that Facebook debating because it used to get to the point where it was just a headache, because the person that I'm debating with is just not understanding. They're not showing proof. They're not backing up this outrageous opinion they have posted for the entire world to see. So I don't even go back and forth with people on the internet no more.
I'm gonna go.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna go back and forth now.
I used to, John, go back and forth with your ass all the time.
You're right.
It got to the point I was like, you know what, this shit is tiring. And every time, even now, I find myself getting ready to debate or throw in my opinion about some shit, and then I'm like, I ain't got time to keep going back and forth with these people. Like, for real. I might say my one little statement and get the hell on. But I remember on one post, I made my little statement, and the little white dude came behind me talking all kind of shit. And he called me something. The black dude whose post I was under, granted, he didn't agree with my opinion, but he came to my defense. He was like, what you will not do is come on my page talking to my black women like this. I was like, damn, okay.
That's how you do it.
Protect Lynch. Keisha got wet.
Splurge.
Whatever. It take more than that, boy. Shut up.
No.
But it was nice. It was nice to be on that aspect of the debate. You feel me? Where, you know, somebody gets offensive using their freedom of speech, and then somebody chime in and be like, yo, you not finna do that. Like, for real. A lot of people don't do that because they want so bad for everybody to like them, and they want to have this platform for people. But if you see somebody that just say something that's just a little bit out the way, whether you agree with their opinion or not, I think you should step up, speak that shit to them. Like, for real, because I see that a lot, like under posts where there's a lot of debating going on, and And men that sit up there, they just sit up there and let other men talk to females any old kind of way. But it was refreshing to actually have a male come to the female defense, and they didn't even have the same opinions. Charlie, what do you want, baby? Okay,
I be rinsing motherfuckers on the board, man. I'm talking about, man. I'm not stopping to the spot, bro. If you get on my Facebook and see what's happening, but you're gonna see just rinsing niggas. Nigga tried to go at me because I told him Texas was trash. You know what I'm saying? We were going for a hot ass, man. He gave up. I was killing his ass. Wayne Governor, that's representative. Nigga, that's your representative. Nigga, you literally voted him in to represent you, bro. So when I see him being trash, he represents you, your whole state trash to me. Now, what are you talking about, bro? It's your guy. He's your representative. I was going in on that nigga.
Yeah, they get mad at me.
But what's the basis?
Hey, I'm going to let that
know. is this. What is the basis behind such an opinion? Like, what is it that you're trying to make people aware of when it comes to Texas being trash? Is it because a lot of people are migrating to Texas and the economy is booming out there? A lot of people are hyping Texas up. What was the reason? What was that reason?
I made it clear to him. But my reason for me telling him that Texas was trash, because that came later. I told him the fun part. I told him why I'm about to say what I'm about to say. But yeah, I said Texas was trash because when that Asian killings happened the next day, everybody, you know, gathering together in Congress, instead of talking about the COVID stuff, they talking about the Asians. And here come goddamn, every time, goddamn Texas governor coming in this motherfucker talking about, well, I want to discuss the freedom of speech. Who says which racist? Where do we draw the line? Nigga, shut the fuck up. People just die. Yeah, we're not here to talk about how you feel. Right, shut up, nigga. So that's when I got on that bitch saying, bro, every time I see some stupid shit being said about something, it's somebody from goddamn Texas, bro. So I said the shit, you know what I'm saying? Here come Dallas, my homeboy Dallas here, executive at AT&T, you know, where the money at. So, you know, they're all conservative as fuck, loyalist. You know what I'm saying? What the hell are you even talking about? So I rinsed his ass off. And then he like, you can't say that because of one leader. I said, that's your state representative, bro. Means he represents you and your people, bro. If you don't agree with how he feel and what he says, then why y'all keep voting him in? Because y'all loyal? Nobody care about that shit, bro. Stop voting the trash people in. You had a mayor at your damn state say, oh, when y'all was freezing and dying, that's y'all problem. What'd he say? Y'all need to figure out how to take care of your family and stuff so they don't get hurt and stuff. You know what I'm saying? The strong will survive. What, nigga? You the mayor. Nobody owes you anything. Right. Nigga, that's tax dollars. You owe them everything. Nigga, that's how you get paid. And then you got Ted Cruz. That nigga damn went to Mexico while they were freezing. Talking about, yeah, I had a vacation plan. Nobody your fault, nigga. It's an emergency. And Texas is the only state that got its own power grid, and it failed. It's privatized. Them niggas making money selling power to their people. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Not the kind of power we be looking for. I'm talking about electricity, my nigga. Yeah. So it's like, it's annoying. Every time I look at Texas, they doing some obviously make the rich richer shit. And then the fucking people that's not rich in Texas trying to defend them and vote for them and then say they don't represent us. Shut the hell up, bro. Y'all retarded. Stop drinking their Kool-Aid. And I told them like this. I said, I promise you,
let more black people migrate to Texas. You saw what black people did with Georgia. We flipped the state. Like, for real. Just allow people. Like, people are traveling. You know, black people are traveling more than they've ever traveled before. And they starting to love Texas. And they moving out there. But surely. You know what? Let it do its thing. And they'll get that governor out of there. Because like we said once, we'll say it again. Kemp, we coming for you. Like, dead ass.
I believe that's going to happen anyway. Because this next generation don't have that loyalist mentality. You know what I'm saying? That mentality, they see that the people before us will lie to you in your face. Just like, if you go to college, you're going to have the best job. Nigga, we did that shit. Well, my dog put it damn good, but everybody didn't get that damn, get lucky like me. You know what I'm saying? The niggas lying. The next generation know that, so they're not going to be loyal to Texas. They're going to do what they think's right. That's why Georgia flipped.
That's the power of the people, man. Shit like we was talking about earlier, cycles and stuff. In the 60s, we all moved to California and out west. We see how that turned out. You know what I mean? So we just got to keep on with that strategy and realize, like, hey, we got more power than what we think. And after a while, we should be running our own stuff, you know? And I feel like we're in the process of that, which is, like, something real good, you know? We just got to keep in mind, like, we can't go wrong where they did, you know? And I believe there was a point in time where white people, they went right where we went wrong. You know, and that's how I kind of feel like they kind of took over the world, like now, as far as like spreading out and stuff. I feel like we had that at first at one point, you know, we just slipped up somewhere along the line. But like now, shit, we just got to do the same thing and like really pay attention. Because if we don't, shit, the same thing going to happen to us, you know.
Yeah. But like I was saying, people have opinions. And, you know, like, what are you going to do behind it? Because, you know, I respect your opinion about Texas. But why not just move down there and be a part of the change? Get that governor out there. Get a register, become a registered voter. Vote the governor out there. Not wanting to do that, then I mean, hey, whether Texas is trash or not, whether it comes out of your mouth, it ain't gonna matter because you don't live there.
You right.
You can do it anywhere.
But I wouldn't know. But I sure tell them about the shit though.
I mean, yeah, you can tell them all you want, but the thing is, you know, it's like you could tell me about being a woman all you want, but unless you actually living as a woman, I ain't gonna really take your opinion serious. That's why I said,
yeah, I know.
Opinions are more, I respect people's opinions when they are backed by personal experience and the ability to actually be a part of the change. That's when I can respect, even if it's a difference of opinion from mine, I can respect it. Okay, yes, you say Texas is trash, and you gave your rundown of why, but what are you going to do to change it? If you're not going to plan on changing it, then why are you even tripping off of it in the first place?
I can tell you that right there. So, one, I ain't going to change it because I don't live in Texas, and I wouldn't nigga that. And the reason I'm tripping about it is because what they do is affecting the country. You know what I'm saying? If they state, like, one of the things I said in there is I wish that Obama would have had to let them concede like they tried to do when he got in. They ran that petition and tried to be their own country. They had their own power grid. I wish Obama would have did that. Then they wouldn't be in our government messing shit up. You know what I'm saying? I would have been fine with that. You know what I'm saying? But that didn't happen. So what they do is in the federal government and affects everybody. They judge on, vote on stuff, do stuff, stop progress on stuff, because that's their thing, you know, they're conservative, they don't want to progress. And it all ends up being this whole extra stuff because of Texas. You know what I'm saying? Now they're trying to be a
cannot become a Texas citizen, become a registered voter, along with the other people that may
right
have
back y'all, my bad.
And then, you know, be a part of the change. Like, that's my whole thing. If you're so upset with the way Texas is handling things in the government, be a part of the change. Like, for real. Just like, I know, like, the people of Georgia were so upset with the way things was going. We went out there and voted at phenomenal rates, and it wasn't even just Black people that turned the state blue. It was everybody who was just sick and tired of the same old bullshit. So, if you're sick and tired of Texas, if you're that passionate about it, be a part of the change. That's all I'm saying. I mean, I can't respect your opinion that Texas is trash and you don't, one, live in Texas, and two, have no intentions on being a part of changing a trash-ass state. And that's just where the whole freedom of speech and canceling and all of this comes from with me. I'm like, man, everybody be trying to cancel something. Like, what you trying to do to change it? Like, for real. If you want to change Pepe Le Pew, if you want to cancel Pepe Le Pew, cool. But how about bring awareness to rape? How about have seminars and programs where these girls know how to fight back? How about providing self-defense classes for little girls ages 3 to 12? That way it's something, you know, the good touch badges, bring all of that back. Canceling Pepe Le Pew does nothing at all. However, if you can instill in these little girls how to fight to protect their bodies, protect their mind, protect their sanity, then okay, boom. Now we getting somewhere.
Yeah, but see, I don't 1,000% agree with that. Like, you talking about making the changes and everywhere, like talking about Texas, I wouldn't, as one individual, go to Texas and try to change Texas. I got my own state. I'm just going to tell them what they should be working on.
You can't do it.
You know what I'm saying?
You could be... Right. You could be,
I wouldn't go over there and make a movement either.
You could be,
because I don't really care about...
You know? So then what's...
Nah, I just don't like the way they deal with the federal government and mess with other stuff, but it's not enough for me to go try to change what they're doing that they've been doing for hundreds of years, but it's enough for me to tell them about the shit. You know what I'm saying?
That's
if I got somebody in the room farting all the time, I'm not going to try to get them to stop farting, but I'm going to tell them, please stop farting. That shit stinking.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Opinion. I mean, that is exactly where I was going with this. Yeah, you can tell them to please stop farting, please stop farting. But I mean, hell, you're gonna find out why they got gas in the first place, like, for real. And if you don't plan on it, then hell, just let it be. If you don't, if that's what you take opinions where they are back behind actual personal experience or wanting to actually change, I'm not canceling nothing unless it's somebody that's actually been through whatever it is that they're trying to get canceled, and you know, it has actually caused a major impact on their life, so to speak, and they're trying to bring awareness to it, this, that, and the third. Like, all this cancel. I'm like, hell, half the time, y'all don't even know why y'all canceling people. Y'all just talking, just talk.
Yeah. I don't, let's see how I can say this. I don't think you have the experience. Like, if you're an intelligent individual to know how to break stuff down, Like, you don't have to be there to experience it, to see what's going on, and then build up the thing. So, like, how I do when I'm working is I gain knowledge, okay? And then I understand that knowledge. That takes time. You get knowledge and understanding, and then that lets you see the big picture. You know what's going on. You understand what's happening. That lets you back up and see the big picture and see where it came from, where we at, and where it can go, okay? And once you put all that together, you got wisdom. That makes wisdom. That means you can see what happened. You see what's going on. You know, if you make these changes, this is where it can go. They call that wisdom. You know what I'm saying? So if you can put all that together, you don't have to sit there and be in the situation to see where it's going to go and be right.
I mean, I kind of get it, but I still don't agree, so to speak. Just like even with racism. When you come across these few people, these white people that, you know, yeah, I support Black Lives Matter because of the race, it don't hit the same when they actually come out of a Black person's mouth. You know what I'm saying? Because we know the oppression. Right. We deal with it day in and day out. And yeah, I appreciate you for having my back. But it just don't hit the same because you don't know what struggles I have personally have gone through as a Black woman. So, I mean, that's just... I mean, like I said, you are entitled to your opinion. If you're going to continue to have one, that's fine. But I always ask people with these strong opinions, hey, what you planning on doing about it?
I'm just going to tell them.
Are you going to do is argue on the internet? That's it.
Well, I don't mean to jump in on y'all's conversation, but I just picked up
a few. Oh, yeah, my bad.
Okay, as far as the argument, like I always thought it was kind of like healthy. As far as like not being disrespectful and like debates and arguments, of course, but just like talking about certain things, I feel like that's something that's been deprived from our people for a long time. And when I say people, I don't necessarily mean just the Black community. I'm talking about people in general.
Bro, I'm doing something.
The reason why we always do get heated at each other is because we don't understand each other. Well, how are we going to understand each other? We got to talk to each other. We got to get in each other's shoes and stuff like that. You know, that's if we're serious about like being united and stuff like that. But that's another side of the coin. As far as just like doing stuff, as far as making the change, like it doesn't always have to be in a big way, you know. And that's not to say change is not big in small ways. Like, I can be talking to somebody in a regular conversation, and I'm making change just like that. Because next time they're in a situation that they're ignorant to before, my simple conversation could help alter it. If you can just plant a seed in somebody's mind, that's really all enough. And that's really all it takes from us, a whole bunch of people doing something little to make a change, you know? So that's like me. Right. Like, man, I argue a simple lie, but it's not necessarily because I'd be mad. I'd be wanting people to get it. I want to plant that seed. So I don't care if it's on WTVM, page or whatever, which is like the best place to argue at. Because like, if y'all never been on there, people really be going in on there. So I like to take advantage of that. So some folks don't be understanding that jump, but like, I think arguments and debating is actually pretty healthy. Now, as far as disrespect, I'm not saying it's a good thing, but I also come to learn that disrespect, it does, like, it has some type of effect, because I can like tell you something, but like some type of cookie cutter response, that doesn't mean it's gonna change you. I'm just another person that's speaking to you, you know? But if you get under their skin a little bit, they're gonna remember it for a little bit longer, you know? So.
Yeah, they're gonna dwell.
I still don't. I unfriended you. I just know it was something stupid.
Man, you know I'll be playing. I ain't talking about
that
you.
Show wasn't that memorable?
Nah, I'll be trolling. That don't be nothing.
I don't know why you trolling. For real, I'm like, man, like, just say that. Sure.
Oh man.
All right. At the end of this episode, we don't cut.
Got him.
You ain't gonna be John like that. No.
You brought him on, Drew. You brought him on, man.
I know, but damn.
Hey, man, Cat got my tongue, man. Cat my tongue.
That's the wrong phrase at this moment, my guy.
Oh, man.
But I tell you, I know me, when I be talking to folk, man, like, see, I ain't no soft dude. You know what I'm saying? I feel like, I'm just going to tell you shit. Everybody know me, I'm going to say this shit. You know what I'm saying? But I always think logically, and I'm gonna plant that seed in your mind, like John was saying. Like I'm gonna give you logic. If you want to argue with me, you gonna have to come with facts. Cause I'm coming with that shit like hard, and I'm gonna get down for you. You know what I'm saying? Then when you keep trying to argue, without using facts, that's when I'm gonna start laying that shit heavy, and you gonna, your feelings gonna be hurt at the end of the day, because like you're not coming at me with nothing, but I got a whole arsenal of facts for you. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, so like I had somebody argue with me yesterday because I had made a comment about the trans kids. You know what I'm saying? Pushing on the kids and stuff, and I came in with like some straight up stuff. You know what I'm saying? They're like, but you don't have kids, so you can never know. Yeah, like, because you had kids, it opened up this new doorway for you. Crackheads got kids. You know what I'm saying? Pedophiles have kids. Bro, that shit going to open up this doorway for you, son. You know what I'm saying? So I don't get
it. If we to have an opinion of that type of subject, but nonetheless, I kind of get what people are going, if you're not a parent, then you're not going to understand. Because there are certain aspects you actually have to be a parent. But with that particular subject, I think it's okay for you to have a opinion about it, because no, you're not a parent today, but you might be one day, and your child is going to go to school with these other kids. How right. do you want your child to handle these types of right. situations? That's perfectly fine, but you're not moving to Texas, so that is where I was going with that.
Right, yeah, so that's going to be good. That's fine. But when I have I think about my sister. When I have a kid, like, I'm always thinking about that. Because the only thing, main thing I was saying was, like, in our generation, people forgot the whole point of the parent in the child's life. Like, there's many different ways to it, and a whole bunch of stuff you're going to add to it. And it can get real complex. But the simple goal is to get that child ready for this world that they're about to be in when you're not there anymore. That's the goal. You know what I'm saying? And, like I said, there's many ways to get there. You know, depending on how you do your parenting, but that's the goal. But a lot of times that goal gets missed because people be trying to be friends too much with the kids and this and that. And then when the kid goes to a church and starts showing up to church, be like, I don't know what happened. You know what I'm saying? Because you weren't getting that care prepared for this world. You know what I'm saying? You was letting the school raise them and stuff. And that was my opinion on the stuff. You know what I'm saying? I had a lot more stuff, but that had to do with the trans and brain development and shit. I ain't want to broke a whole new subject in this month, but and that's what I basically was saying. That she was like, you can't speak on that because you don't have kids. Nigga, I don't need to have kids to understand what you need to do when you're a parent for your child to be successful in this world. They need to be ready for the world. If you have a kid and they're not ready for the world, then what are they going to do when they get out here?
Oh, my God.
They're not ready for it. They're going to struggle. You know what I'm saying? I feel like 2 + 2 = 4.
Yeah, parenting does have its ups and downs. I have a 15-year-old and I have a 5-year-old, and I promise you, my 5-year-old, she'd be fine out there in the world, but my 15-year-old, I can't send her out there just yet, so.
And you saw changes from when your 15-year-old was young to now, right?
Well, here's the thing. I just got guardianship over my 15-year-old, so that's why. Gotcha. We're still a work in progress.
Gotcha. Okay. Yeah, because my main point with you telling these kids to be trans, and then when they hit puberty, they ain't going to know how they feel. You feel me?
Yeah.
People act like kids ain't kids no more. They don't have puberty. You know what I'm saying? They don't, you know, it's going to be a whole issue. But, you know, I don't know. I feel like I won that argument. And we'll see how the world is when I get there. And then I'll slide through Facebook and be like, I told you, nigga.
I wish I still had my MySpace page just to see the crazy shit I was saying back then.
We living in a whole different world, man. Just like, to me, this shit, all this shit was based and centered around bullying. That's where it started, the bullying. So they, like, to me, they want to eliminate everything so person could potentially get bullied on. So that's what I'm thinking. That's where it comes from.
Yeah, America, the land of pimps and hoes. That's what it's always been about.
Yeah, exactly. Somebody
dollar bill, y'all.
Shit. It ain't gonna stick. It ain't gonna stick in the long run. It's generational, man. The generation, like, so our generation gonna do our thing. We surviving. We had it the hardest, you know, because we've been through so many economic hits on the way to trying to be successful. The next generation gonna see already, like, the shit we went through. They trying to avoid that and kill racism and sexism, and then they gonna be fucked up just because all this sex changing and all this. They all gonna hit puberty and be confused. Somebody gonna shoot somebody. I don't know. I watch ID. I watch Discovery Plus. I got that shit. I watched them serial killers. All of them were set to be, and shit wasn't right. You know what I'm saying? Somebody touched them over here. And if your kid come back to you talking about Jay and shit, or he gay and shit, I feel like you need to investigate a little bit. Because when I watched ID, somebody was touching them, and they thought they were gay. Then they hit puberty and didn't understand why they weren't enjoying that shit. So they went harder and harder and harder. And then next thing you know, they're killing people. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. I feel like it's going to be a whole slew of problems with this next generation coming up. But then a lot of shit slide. You know what I'm saying? While they counseling shit and everybody going with the counseling shit, they need to be kind of focused on the kids and be like, hey, what you really thinking about? What's going on? How you feeling today? You know what I'm saying? You know this world don't give a shit about you, right? So we need to toughen you up so you can get out there and survive when it's your time. You know what I'm saying? But right now, we're so worried about pandering to kids, man. We got, I don't know, man. It's going to be wild, man. But I think the generation after that is going to be like, damn, all these people's crazy as hell. Let's bounce back and be regular.
Yeah, that one thing. Generation definitely soft now. The one that's coming up,
just soft. Getting the ability to think for themselves, like for real, think for yourself. That is the only way you're gonna be able to maneuver through life is if you can think for yourself and you're not following on other people. For real, if you have, it's okay to have a difference of opinion. It's okay to say no when you see something going on and you don't want to participate in it. It is okay to be your own person, like for real. I was telling the 15-year-old, I said, you know, I didn't always smoke weed. As a matter of fact, I was one of the only ones out of my crew that did not smoke weed. And it wasn't because I thought anything about weed. It just wasn't for me. So when the blunt came my way, I knew how to say, no, thank you. You know what I'm saying? Like, and that was at 15 years old. So you got to be able to just be your own person and be headstrong in who you are. And believe in that shit. And you're right, though. Like you said, D.Green, like, for real. When it comes to your sexuality, yes, I'm going to ask questions. And I'm not asking questions because I have a problem with the sexuality. I'm going to have questions because are you being influenced by the media? Or is this really who you are? Because if this is really who you are, I'm all for it with you. But there are people that have died and been murdered because of their sexuality. This is that is technically a different form of civil right. So if you're going to live that life, make sure that is your life and that you're standing behind it. As long as you know that is who you are and who you want to be, I'm gonna support you regardless.
Yeah, man.
I think
puberty too. When puberty hit, you know, it's different. Go ahead, my
y'all ever feel like sexuality kind of like set the standards for masculinity in a different way?
Yeah.
I ask people sometimes, like, imagine if Michael Jackson, Lil Richard, James Brown, or those other folks was like born in like our day. Like the same people, you know, nothing changed. Of course, it'll be a little different because they came up in our time, but you know, the same, like more careers, the same charisma and everything. Like, how do y'all think they would be labeled? Do you think they'll be pressured or kind of like spellcasted into being gay? You know, just because of like everybody has their own like perception of what a gay person is and all that? Or do you think they would have stayed straight?
I think they'll stand in their own lane because here's the thing. We'll take Prince, for example. We never quite figured out his sexuality. Like, he had
evidently he was straight. He had a lot of women.
Beautiful wife, but you look like, damn, you wearing heels.
Right.
He can play ball.
And on
too.
The other coin, you got you got a guy like Aaron Hernandez. You know, the as far as look wise, you know, you would think he's like, you know, more of a masculine figure, you know, but then you find out stuff about him, you know. So it's just makes you wonder, like, what's really, you just gotta be your own person, like Lakeisha.
Exactly,
was saying,
be your own person. That's why nobody really cared about their sexuality, because it was like, yo, Prince is the man. That's what we know. That's my boy, point blank, period. And then not only that, Prince was like, you know. Oh man, his pro-blackness was off the chain. So it's like you had no choice but to respect the man because for one, he was intelligent and he was talented. So yeah, I mean it was
humble as hell too.
Your own person.
Yeah.
I still play Purple Rain to this day.
Man,
Purple Rain.
the beautiful ones.
It's like my favorite song. Like,
that's my shit though.
Yeah. I think that was people just need to learn to be themselves. Fitting in is what fucking fitting in is really what fucking everything up.
Yeah.
I don't want to fit in. I'm gonna agree with you on this bullshit. Knowing damn well this shit ain't who I am, but I'm agree with you because the thing to be.
Yeah. A lot of people do that shit.
Maybe. It's rough in society, bro. Go ahead, Drewski.
Oh, no, I was just about to say, nobody, they be trying to fit in, they never get no point across, nothing. Basically, like we were saying before, like a yes man. Just agree and shit, just to agree with shit, just to fit in.
Yeah.
I know, like me, I ain't never fit in, bro. Like, I always stood. I got ADHD, nigga, so I was always, like, doing too fucking much. No, but I ain't never fit in, bro. Like, anybody know me, like, I always stood out. Me and myself, like, a trash. Yeah, a lot of y'all probably know I got a sister. I ain't talked to her in 12 years. I don't get fucked with her for real like that. But, like, me and her was at the same level. We went through the same bullshit growing up. Like, our life wasn't easy growing up when we grew up at and shit. Did better than she did because she used it as a crutch and shit. Want to be like, oh, my life's trash and shit. Yeah. And I did my thing with it. I like, make me strong, bro. I'm a beast. What's going to slow me down? And then we got out here. I tried to tell her back and that she'd be jealous of me because everybody wanted to kick it with D.Green. You know what I'm saying? And I'd be like, to be yourself. You're so busy trying to fit in. Everybody see that shit, bro. You're trying so hard. Nobody want to be around you. That shit ugly. You know what I'm saying? Be yourself and be yourself with some confidence and people will flock around you. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what they wish they could do. You know what I'm saying? Right. They wish they could just be themselves with confidence. And that's all I ever did because I don't need nobody. All I need is this PlayStation 5, my dog, and some fucking food. I'm good. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I don't need nobody. So I'd be myself with confidence and people be wanting to, D.Green, what you doing today? Me trying to kick it, man. You know, I'm on the game, bro, but we could talk for a quick second. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what's wrong with this world. And I always felt like I was fucked up. Something was wrong with me. You know what I'm saying? Because I was always the different one. But now, as I get older, I'm 30 now. Like, something wrong with this world, bro. Everybody trying to be everybody. Everybody trying to wear the same shit. Do the same shit. Like, do your own thing.
Everybody wants to feel special. And they want the world to make them feel special. And I be like, yo, all that's not necessary. It is not necessary. And unfortunately, that is why the depression rate with teenagers is growing so high. Because these kids are trying to be like what they're seeing on the internet. And I'm like, yo, you ain't got to. You don't have to. Because I was that type of person too. I pretty much found my own way. And like my friends, and I told my 15-year-old, I'm like, yo, if you haven't noticed, I hardly go over to my friend's house. They usually come over here. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't be that person that's always going. Have people, you know, you special. Have people come to you too. Hell.
Yeah.
Yes, and you're too, Charlie.
I'm 14 too. Charlie!
Yeah. Yeah, I used to try to fit in like the bad type of crowd. Just try to like be noticed and all that shit to the point I forgot they started gang banging and shit. They asked me, was I down? I said, nah, bro. Fuck all that.
That's what they did. Are you down with us or not?
I'm too goofy for that shit. No. Like I say, just be yourself, and like D.Green said, everybody will start respect that more.
Well, I always be myself. I think that's why people like love my back. I don't care. Everybody on here like this know me except John. I'm the same person. I'm not doing too much. I'm just me. Like people like. You know, y'all know it's people out here wanna goddamn just like everybody they meet, they got a face or a personality for everybody they meet. I'm over like you said, they gang bangs over here, so I'm gonna act like I'm in the gang. They on drug deals over here, so I'm finna act like I'm selling drugs. They rapping over here, like so I'm finna act like I'm rapping. These niggas like that. Grown people, grown as hell, like 30 still doing that shit. Like shit's crazy.
Wow. Yeah, this is not but that.
When I said like when I first met D.Green, like he like how he is now, like he always gonna speak his mind about something. He gonna come with it. So that's why I respected him back at Columbus Tech. And with John, we usually like hang out like used to meet up at like kickbacks and stuff. But I see we post on Facebook, like he gonna keep it real and all that. So like I said, I respect y'all more for speaking y'all mind and stuff and everybody else in the podcast, because that's how we come with it.
Remember the first time we met?
Be looking like that, Keisha.
Well, the first time I met Mike, I was kind of suspicious. I didn't want to be around him no more.
I was off the bat real. That nigga said, "What's up?" I said, "Don't talk to me. I'm crazy as fuck."
I took my ass to the bus. I took my ass to the school bus.
I said, "I'm gonna go back to Germany." Because I could see him doing some shit like that. You like a weirdo.
He didn't say it calm like that. He yelled at me. And I got on the school bus. I said, I want to go back to Jordan. I'm sick of this shit.
Damn, Mike.
Hello. I'm fucking with him because it was the first time I seen him. He was like, what's up? Don't talk to me. I'm crazy.
And they said, you ain't making a friend today, nigga.
You're fucking with him.
And then the next thing you know, we got class together. We had class next semester. I said, this nigga really ain't crazy.
I had to grow on Drew. I could tell I had to grow on Drew.
Well, Drew
look at me with a blank stare face.
Oh. like, what is your problem?
Shoot, I was good at two shoes growing up, man. Shoot, I like was through the motions, but I didn't really like know myself. Like me personally, I never really found out, like, I'll say to be confident in myself till I was probably about 26 years old, man. But that's when I really just started like doing my own thing and just. Like, really,
why are you still talking about your height?
My height.
Oh my God.
Oh man.
See, me and John about the same height, so I ain't gonna let you do them like
this. I was gonna ask you and John.
Man, look, man, short man, we're taking over. Like, we done talked about the interracial takeover in the future and all that, but short man, we taking over, man. We got Kurt Franklin. Cuss his kids out. You don't see Fred Hammond or the Don McClurkin, nobody cussing their kids out, but Kurt Franklin did it. Kurt Franklin played basketball.
That's like
you got Lil Wayne. I ain't gonna say too much about Wayne right now, but we know what Wayne did. Sure, man, we taking over, man.
We got Plies too.
Plies, yep.
Mm-hmm. Tom Nasty.
I ain't gonna mention Bow Wow, but you know we got other folks.
Hey, Prince.
We got Prince, oh yeah.
You know, you're not finding yourself and getting confident, though. You probably had you had some good parents.
Talking about me?
John.
Yeah. My folks, they real solid, man. Really instilled.
That would it be, man. That pain and struggle make you learn fast. But, you know what I'm saying? I go over and open part. My shit trash, but we was ganged up, all that shit. But you got to grow up early then, you know what I'm saying? So shit, we was already like on some grown man shit, you know what I'm saying? Going on hunts at like 12 and shit, looking for these females and shit, and little teenagers was fucking with us. And then got down, like we had to fight grown men and shit. Like you really learn this world don't care about you at a young age. And at that point, you just got to decide how you're going to go from that point. You got to have confidence in yourself or you're going to die here. Not maybe literally, but like mentally and spiritually, you just going to fade away into nothing. So I said, I wasn't finna go out like that because I ain't soft like that, nigga. I've been through too much bullshit to be no soft ass nigga. So I came through, dog. Now, my teachers had to teach me how to be soft so I could take care of other people. You know what I'm saying? It was a process, but see, I feel like I'm doing pretty damn good. I'm better than I was when Travis used to know me.
Yeah.
I ain't that whole Ashton situation, but I'm finna shut the whole damn Trojan Center down.
Yeah, man. Somebody grow. That's more. Learn how to be yourself, man. That shit. Yeah. That shit will save a lot of shit and help a lot of people.
You gotta walk your own path, man.
Yeah. Do your own shit.
Listen, my lord, we live in such a materialistic world.
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck about none of that shit you got. It does nothing for me.
That's why I think we got one of the greatest, if not the greatest podcast. Cause this us, we just be talking. Mm-hmm. These be our real experience. Like we ain't following nobody, we ain't scripting this shit. We just go in and talk what we go through and shit. Like so, hey man,
only thing scripted about us.
Yeah, this shit live.
Only thing what?
Only thing script about us is the ad we make.
Ooh, shit. New ad alert. Ooh, shit. And the intro.
Shit, now. Man, I got them. I've been, you said cut by that materialistic stuff. I ain't gonna flat, man. I've been down buying all the materialistic shit, bro.
I mean, you know what I mean? What you do with your money is your business. If you feel like you deserve it, then get it. I buy nice things. I buy nice things, but hell, the world don't need to know I got my nice things. That's what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, I'm not all
yeah.
Like, I just caught the such and such. Like, I got a bunch of nice ass shit that I rather people just not know. Like, if you just see me out and about with a certain
right, person, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And just. It is. Yeah, I just
hate when people knock hard. Other folks for not doing it.
Yeah, I work very hard. Yeah. So yes, I'm going to spend money on myself and these kids. Yeah, but
the ones that be flexing up with them, the ones that get robbed.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, well, I mean, there's been so much that has
I'll be airing mine.
I don't share those aspects of my life on social media because I don't want validation from nobody. I buy what I buy because one, I can afford it. Two, I work hard. And three, I deserve it. So,
yeah,
that's all that matters. It's all about me when it comes
I
ain't
to floss my shit. I want y'all to know that I like a Nietzsche jeans and FUBU. I'm trying to welcome you to my place. Come in my spot, you're gonna be disappointed.
Wow.
Got fat farm shoes. Let's get out of here.
And Molo. E-N-Y, big Y, C.
She said fat farm shoes. Yeah, damn.
Fat farm shoes. All right.
This ain't Molo, this is Buckhead.
Thought it was PA on deck, man.
Then the people that get robbed.
Real shit.
Say what?
I'm no fan. Reed on the P. I be padded with this shit because a lot of niggas that said I'm not gonna be shit. You know what I'm saying? They were like, oh, that nigga just a hood nigga. Yeah. Shit, man. I got done. So now. First thing I did was get that degree on their ass. The nigga was surprised. Oh, D.Green did something with himself. Yeah, nigga. Nah, I be shitting on their ass, bro. I be getting all kind of stupid shit. I made sure I post that bitch too so they can see. I know they be seeing that shit. They'll say, because we're in a better situation. They're supposed to do better than me. They were telling their homeboy, oh, yeah, that nigga D.Green don't know how to do nothing but sell drugs and shit. All right. So now the nigga be seeing that shit. I'm petty like that, though, I guess.
That's on you. But I mean, you'd be surprised. A lot of people just you try to prove something to them, and they be like, okay, and
but I don't say nothing about it. I just
congratulations.
Hey, I'm gonna work on it.
Man, some folks just be listening with a jealous mind, man. But you know,
I mean, they could be doing that too, but I'd be like, congratulations. I mean, my thing is this, and I preach this all the time to my baby, like, hey, you going to be a product of your environment? Or you going to be a success story?
Right. So, get out of that one way or the other.
That story, that's great. All good things that come to you, you deserve it. So, hey, yeah. Ain't nobody been there. As long as you happy, that's all that matters. Because the nice things I got don't make nobody else happy.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Wow.
How
long been on about it? I'll figure it, you know what I'm saying? Wrap it on up.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Definitely been an hour.
Good talking to you,
Jen. Appreciate
both of y'all coming on. You know what I'm saying?
Appreciate you, man.
I'm sending y'all shirt or something. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm trying to do for our guests. Send y'all shirts,
man,
merch. You know what I'm saying? Again, we appreciate y'all coming on.
Oh, hey.
Hey, John.
Just got in last words.
Excuse Keisha's comment earlier. We're going to edit that.
I put that throw on some Dior's or Juventus or something.
She better send me a friend request.
As you man, wait.
You get all the free Gen Talk merch just for a comment.
No, he sure.
Yes, he do.
You need to tell me my one comment, and he admitted that he keep trolling me. He admitted it.
But you took it far.
But it's cool though, because ain't nobody gonna get canceled.
Anybody got some last words or something?
Shit. Nah, I appreciate y'all niggas, you know, putting me on and shit. Let me enjoy a little conversation with y'all intellectual ass people.
I enjoyed you.
We appreciate it. Enjoy it too.
Appreciate y'all having me on. It's cool talking to everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. If y'all ever want to come back on, just let us know.
Oh, yeah. I'd love to come back, man. Right. Let me know. Drew, appreciate you hearing me. Let me know if you need anything.
But you know, Drew, I have to have a word with you when this show is over with.
I'm going to bed.
Oh, my God.
I'm going straight to bed. I'm sorry.
We're going to have a good conversation about loyalty, my nigga.
You send that friend request.
Send me shit.
Oh, man.
I'm friending you. What I look like refriending you. If you want me to be your friend, you ask me.
I got some.
Hey, it ain't about what they think. It's about what you answer to.
If you want, exactly. If you want me to be your friend, that ass, then I'll do it. I can either accept or reject.
I see a lot of tension.
Mike, you do the outro.
We don't know each other. Like, we beefing. Like, Mike, me and him been beefing for, like, months. Well, no, I'm not really beefing.
You can make that comment, but you can send a friend request.
He been trolling. He been trolling me, Mike. He been bullying me. He got mad at me because he started getting roasted. Like, he got roasted into oblivion, and I fell asleep, and I was supposed to help him out. He was like, where the hell is she? I was getting my ass handed to me. I'm like, oh, wow, you really was. Damn.
And I ain't say that. I said it because you was like 7-1 or something, he said.
Oh, yeah, I was keeping
score. Yeah, you was keeping score, yeah. And yeah, I was like, how you going to keep score and hit me out, man?
Damn.
Yeah. I did do that, and I was supposed to help, and I didn't.
Yeah, I'm on, though, so it's all good.
See, the first step is acceptance.
That's all matter.
All I'm going to say is God is good. That's all I'm going to say. God is good.
All the time.
Y'all have a good night. I am going to, I don't know. I'm up now.
Just be safe.
Yeah.
Right. Hey, I'm about to finish packing up my.
Trav, you know I'm about to walk out that door. Yeah, I know. I'm gonna put on my shoes.
No, I said she ain't gonna hold you too long.
I'm not going nowhere.
Oh, you can go ahead and do it, Trav.
I had too much fun last night, so yeah, I can't have too many more of those nights in a row.
Go ahead and knock it off, Trav.
Thank you, everybody, listening to Gen Talk, man. This has been the Gen Talk, you know. Tell everybody a good night. Drew, you doing the mic noise or not?
Nope. Everybody sleep.
I'll do it.
Good night to TV Land.
You know, our logo, our motto, we in the jungle, baby.
Draw. Wait.
Hey, the price is going up this summer, baby. They say it's a sleeper. The ears are real. The petty is real. Might charge my ex for a feature. Deposit the money to Brenda Leticia. Linda Felicia, she came for me twice. I didn't need enough for her once. You know I'm a pleaser. 42 millimeter was made in Geneva. Yeah, I probably should go to Yeshiva. We went to Ibiza. Yeah, I probably should go link with Yeezy. I need me some Jesus. But soon as I started confessing my sins, he wouldn't believe us. Sins, I got sins on my mind and some M's.